Dear students, today we are going to see the orientation of Industrial Pharmacy 1 practical subject. So, as per the Pharmacy Council of India, Industrial Pharmacy 1 practical subject is given a special code, that is BP506P. In this subject, the number of experiments which are given in the syllabus are 11 in number. But for the convenience of you students, I have divided this experiment in following 15 experiments through which we are going to cover the whole syllabus of Industrial Pharmacy 1 practicals. Let's see the titles of the experiments which we have under this subject. So the first experiment which we have is for chapter pre-formulation, in which we are going to perform pre-formulation studies on a drug paracetamol, in which we are going to study certain organoleptic characteristics, then flow properties, then we are going to see the densities such as tap density, bulk density, porous density. Then the second experiment is regarding preparation and evaluation of paracetamol tablets, in which we are going to prepare paracetamol tablets and evaluate these prepared paracetamol tablets for its quality control as per Indian Pharmacopoeia and USA, that is United States Pharmacopoeia. The third experiment is regarding preparation and evaluation of aspirin tablets, in which we are going to prepare aspirin tablets. Later on, we are going to evaluate the prepared aspirin tablets as per IP and USP. Fourth experiment is from coating, in which we are going to coat tablets with the help of film coating by using suitable film coating polymers. In fifth experiment, we are going to coat granules with the help of film coating. Sixth experiment is regarding preparation and evaluation of capsules, in which we are going to prepare tablets in which we are going to prepare capsules of tetracycline and later on evaluate it. Experiment number 7 is from the parenteral doses form, in which we are going to prepare and evaluate large volume parenterals, in which we are going to prepare calcium gluconate injection. We are going to carry out certain evaluation tests such as sterility test, then test for pyrogens and other tests, as they are not feasible to be carried out in a college setup. So we are going to go with sterility test. Then in the same way, we are going to prepare another dosage form from parenteral class, in which we are going to prepare a small volume parenteral, that is ascorbic acid injection. Then in experiment number 9, we are going to carry out the quality control test for some marketed tablets as per Indian Pharmacopoeia. In experiment number 10, we we are going to carry out quality control test for marketed capsules as per IP. In the same way, we have some dosage form from the category of ophthalmic products. So in experiment number 11, we are going to prepare eye drops and do evaluation of this eye drops. Then in experiment number 12, we have preparation of eye ointment by aseptic technique and evaluation of this. Then we have some formulations from the category of cosmetics, in which we are going to prepare cold cream in experiment number 13. In experiment number 14, again from the class of cosmetic, we are going to prepare a vanishing cream and carry out evaluation test on it. And the last experiment, as per the syllabus, is of evaluation of glass containers as per IP. So these are the 15 experiments which we have to conduct in our industrial pharmacy one practical subject or course. Now the recommended books as per the Pharmacy Council of India for industrial pharmacy one are, first, pharmaceutical doses form tablets volume 1-3, which is written by H. A. Lieberman, Leon Lackman and J. B. Scotts. Then we have second book which is recommended from PCI is pharmaceutical doses form parental medication volume 1 and volume 2, again from a Decker series, written by Lieberman and Lackman. Then we have pharmaceutical doses form dispersed system volume 1 by Lieberman and Lackman. So all these first three books are from the Decker series. Then the fourth book which has been recommended by PCI is Modern Pharmaceutics by Gilbert S. Banker and C.T. Rose, the third edition. Then other books which PCI has recommended are Remington, The Science and Practice of Pharmacy, 20th edition. Then we have The Theory and Practice of Industrial Pharmacy, that is Lackman. Then we have Pharmaceutics, The Science of Dosage Form Design by M.E. Alten. Then Introduction to Pharmaceutical Dosage Form, which is written by S.C. Ansel. Then the last book which has been recommended by PCI is Drug Stability Principles and Practice by Carlton and C.G. Rose. Now for the course of Industrial Pharmacy 1, the code which has been given by as per IPC, that is PCI, sorry, it is BP506P. So BP stands for Bachelor in Pharmacy, 5 stands for your 5th semester, and 06 stands for subject number 6, which is a practical subject. Now the course delivery for Industrial Pharmacy 1 practicals will be delivered through practicals, demonstration, conduct of experiments, formulation, labeling, evaluation of dosage forms or packaging materials, lectures, interactions, discussions, viva voce, assignments and presentation. So these are various ways by which we are going to deliver the content for Industrial Pharmacy 1 practical. The And after completion of this BP506P Industrial Pharmaceutical Practical Course, you students will be able to understand and appreciate the influence of pharmaceutical additives and the various pharmaceutical dosage forms on the performance of the drug product. In short, after completion of this course, you will be in a position to know which kind of excipients goes in dosage forms such as tablets, capsules, then liquid orals, then ophthalmic product, then parenteral product, how we are going to go and carry out the quality control test for packaging materials. Then the objectives are as follows. Upon completion of the course, the students shall be able to know the various pharmaceutical dosage forms and their manufacturing techniques. Know various considerations in development of pharmaceutical dosage forms. And lastly, formulate solid, liquid and semi-solid dosage forms and evaluate them for their quality. So in this, from solid category, we are going to formulate tablets, granules. Then we are going to coat some solid dosage forms such as tablet and granules. Then from the liquid category, we are going to prepare eye drops. Then we are going to prepare large volume parenterals and small volume parenterals. From semi-solid category, we are going to prepare ophthalmic ointments. And also we are going to prepare certain creams such as vanishing cream and cold cream. And later on, evaluate them for their quality. So these are the course outcomes which I have designed for Industrial Pharmacy 1 course. So I have designed this 5 course outcome based on the Bloom's taxonomy, which are as follows. So CO1 is conduct, in which we are going to in which we have a Bloom's level taxonomy of, that is L2, that is understanding. So conduct pre-formulation studies and evaluate, where we have a Bloom's taxonomy, that is L5, evaluating drugs or excipient for physicochemical properties. Then we have course outcome 2, in which we have two levels of Bloom's taxonomy, that is L6 and L5, that is creating and evaluating, in which the course outcome states, formulate, evaluate and label the prepared tablet, granules and capsule. In the same way, course outcome 3 and 4 has been prepared for parenteral and ophthalmic products and for semi-solid dosage forms, in which we have level 6 and level 5 for Bloom's taxonomy. And course outcome 5 is evaluate, in which we have level 5 as per Bloom's taxonomy. So evaluate or evaluation of packaging materials as per IP/USP or British Pharmacopoeia. So this is the first video for Industrial Pharmacy 1 practicals, in which we have seen regarding the syllabus as per PCI, how the course will be delivered, what are the objectives and what are the course outcomes for Industrial Pharmacy 1 practicals as per PCI syllabus. Thank you for listening this video. The second part will be the continuation of the same video. Thank you.